Go Cubs!
What is going on, guys? My name is Dimitri and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, we're going to break down my minimalist Notion workspace. So as you guys know, if you are a previous viewer of the channel, I am a minimalist, I'm a productivity enthusiast, and I really like the colors black and gray, and colors overall are not exactly my thing because I'm colorblind, but in my minimalist Notion workspace, oh, the icons are like gray. It's pretty cool. And I want to show you guys, in all seriousness, my minimalist Notion workspace, what I do on a daily basis, kind of what I glance at. And I think it'd be great if I dive into my Notion workspace with you guys. And this is going to be a more sort of, you know, me just like casually showing you things. And I think it'd be great if that happened. And then there's feedback given at the end of the video from you guys in the comment section about what different aspects about it do you want to know about. So before we get into that, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe and hit the notification bell as well so you can stay up to date with all of the latest videos on my YouTube channel. With that being said, let's dive into my workspace. So this is my minimalist Notion workspace. I think diving into this is going to be really good. It's something I haven't gone over in a while, and I've really been, I don't know, I've been finicking a lot with things, and I've been working through some things. So that's why I've kind of put this video off for a while. But with Notion sync blocks, it's kind of made things a little bit more, let's say, bearable in regards to like the global header situation. Because just first and foremost, in Notion, you have the option to obviously have this set up. I can't stand that. I'm not a big fan of it. I don't know what it is. I think it's because it takes up less space. It's less minimal. But anyways, I think what would be good here is if I broke down mainly what's on this top bar, right? And but first give you a brief overview of everything overall. So as you can see, this is my Dimitri's Notion workspace. So this is kind of here, right? This is a Notion synced block that is a global header. I made a video on that if you want to go check it out. But essentially what this does is it gets me to everything I need to in regards to like weekly stuff that's pretty consistent. And this Notion workspace has things segmented into different areas. So I don't have school anymore. This is actually kind of crazy. So what I'm doing on this video is a joke, is the fact that I actually have like this whole backup page. It's in backups. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna say goodbye to that. And I thought that'd be funny to do. But anyways, I have everything in here in regards to a lot of what I need. And the nice thing about my Notion workspace is that when I get into the main parts of it, so like my daily planner and stuff, a lot of this other stuff kind of goes in there. So this is more just like, you know, something that's there. This is not something I utilize much. A lot of this stuff is, you know, looked at less, my more goals and ideas oriented things. Then we have work stuff, which is more like side hustle things that aren't Rise Productive related. So like I've been interested in doing a lot of different things. So the job applications is obviously the one thing, but like freelance projects, you know, I've done freelance work before, and I think that's something good to get into for anyone who's interested. But this area is not as much used. So mainly where we're going to be living is schedule and tasks and Rise Productive. So as you can see, it's kind of segmented into, so the hub is actually for Chance and I to communicate on Notion. And hopefully we can do a little bit of a breakdown of the hub in here. But basically we have everything in here that's needed. Schedule and task, you know, this stuff on the bottom here is less used, but this is all something I use on a consistent basis. So diving into first the daily plan, as you can see on the global header, this is here, right? So basically everything that's needed outside of challenges, I believe, from Rise Productive is on the global header. And then these first three are on the global header. So let's go into Daily Planner. So Daily Planner is a busy space for me. This is where I work a lot. This kind of seems a little bit intense, and you can see I have backups at the bottom. But I do a lot of different things. I do task batching, I do Google Calendar, I do, you know, the daily highlights. So all these different things need to kind of show up here, as well as, you know, there are some small things in here that's nice. Like I have what social media posts I have for the day here. I have my Chicago and weather so that I know what the weather is going to be like rather than having to open up the app. I have a place to quickly jot down content ideas. So all of these things kind of come into place, as well as, you know, a notes database and a journal. So basically, the first thing I do in the morning is, or actually at the beginning of the week, a lot of times I do this, is I will set up what my daily highlight is for the day. So my daily highlight for today, which is basically what I want to do, is, yeah, the most out of anything in the day, is
actually this. So create new Notion videos. And I actually recorded one right before this. So this is something that is my daily highlight, right? And the cool thing about this is I have this all set sort of in a way that it just shows like what my daily stuff is. So as you can see, the habit tracker wasn't on the global header. However, it was in my workspace thing and in that first row, and it populates here as well as the other things here. And the nice thing is if I click here and do the notes, it makes a notes for today, right? So then I can connect it to what? Notion. I type Notion videos. I connect it to the weekly sort of daily highlight scenario that I have down there that disappears after I finish them for the week. I go and type create new Notion videos, today's journal, and then I can Notion API and workspace video. And then at night I can reflect and just do my normal journaling, which is great. And it's all within this main page. That was kind of just a showcase of what this has for you. You know, it has my Google Calendar synced up here. So I know that I need to get and stop working and get showered and get out the door to go to work, you know, by a certain time. So then we go to my next page, which is this task list event calendar. And I'd say what's really nice about this is it's also got a similar setup, but more at a monthly sort of view. It'd be great if Notion had weekly views, but they just don't. And I got to just, you know what? I got to deal with it. So we have things in this regard, right? We have what's cool is like the Notion Rise Productive Hub is connected with this. This is just like a monthly view of like my task management system. I put a lot of different work into this. You know, there is all the different segments here of task group, the tags. So when I make something and a task that goes in here, it then goes into my daily planner and populates on the specific day that I open up the daily planner, which is great. And then they disappear when tasks are clicked off. And this is something where it doesn't really disappear. This is more just like what exists, right? I don't really want to make it disappear. But as you can see, this is kind of like my view, and I basically coincide this with my Google Calendar, right? So I'll like basically take this on two different screens or split the screens and see what the time blocks I have available for doing different tasks are, and then I'll put it into here. I've made a video on that before, my main Notion video. That is still how I do things, so I would go and check that out if you want. But basically down here I still have my weekly sort of daily highlights, right? And then I have a place for content ideas. I have all of my unsorted to-dos. So the nice thing about this page and something new that I made, this is a suggestion by Danny Hatcher, is these are all linked databases, and like they are pasted in there, right? So what you do if you want to ever make a relational database is you copy the link from the main thing, you paste it somewhere, because this is all kind of formatted funny. So you can paste this linked database, right? And then you filter it out or whatever, and then it does things like this. It can filter out unsorted to-dos, so things that don't have anything, but I have a nice setup in regards to a nice little integration with Todoist, where I take a jotted little idea on my phone, it goes into the unsorted to-dos, and that's like an automation through the API. I may make a video on Todoist at one point. I think that'd be a good reference point here. And it's just really, it's nice to have ideas just immediately get into like an actual to-do list that is more actionable. And basically when I plan twice a week, this is where I get my ideas and I pull them up. So now what's nice is rather than having to create these every week, I have an automation that makes, you know, all of the different tasks that I need to, and I pull them into my task/event calendar, which is awesome. Then the next thing here really quick is I have a training plan calendar. So I work out a lot. Obviously I ran track in college and I am on my off time right now, which is really nice, but this kind of stuff, this populates daily into what I need to do workout wise. And then I have an automation through the Notion API that connects from Strava and gets like the actual information as to what I did back, right? So this is just kind of nice, you know, like it auto populates in there after I run. So I get to see like, this is what I planned on doing, and this is like what actually ended up happening. It gives the time and stuff. So some of these Strava titles are coming in, which is funny. And then if we go to the next thing, this is just a hub in regards to like where I'm working with Chance. You know, we recorded episode 52. We actually recorded episode 53. This is a new working space, so I haven't kept up to date with it as much, and we're still trying to work through some kinks there. But what's nice is that, as you can see, it's kind of got a nice flow to it, and it's all connected. This is where I show myself, okay, what is my week supposed to look like in regards to tasks, while the Google Calendar is what it's supposed to work looking like, the different blocks that I have and the time I have to create the stuff. And this helps me plan too. So as you can see, usually I'll have like, what is this, 5:30 to 6:30 a.m. on Tuesdays to get stuff done, which is exactly where I added my podcast clips, right? And this is a board view, and this is something that's, you know, it's very static, but it's a great reference point. So now when I have my weekly to-do list automated in there, I can quickly see, okay, where do they need to go? Okay, I need to put this on a specific day. And I don't have them automatically set to these times due to the fact that, you know, time does not go exactly how you want always. Then when we finish that, we go into like my content ideas area, which is really, really extensive and interesting. We have a lot of things here where we can filter out the different part of the content ideas. And none of this is the actual content ideas page, actually. It's like a database in here, right? But it's all about the views and data, from what I've learned, especially recently with my job, is all about how you showcase it to those that need it. And what we have here is we really have the entirety of my ideas, and they actually kind of then go away on this page, because it doesn't really matter if they're associated with a YouTube video anymore. Like, this is like the working ideas. So the second this gets associated with a podcast, this will disappear. So name, image, likeness, I think we're going to talk about for episode 54, actually. I think we've chalked that up to being what it is. So if I do this, right, we go, oh, no, 53. 53. Nope, 55, I can't count. It disappears. I was trying to make a point there, but it disappears after you get to 56 when I actually figure out the right one. So this is like all the ideas I have, and so like this is spoilers, but also not spoilers because I'm not really sure. This is still a work in progress, but this, as you can see, there's kind of a flow here. There's a spot where it lies in my daily planner, and then if it's important enough, and in my content calendar if it's important enough, and then everything else is smaller and segmented in there. So then we have, you know, my YouTube, which has my content calendar in there and stuff. We have my podcast, which has my content calendar in there and stuff. There's really not much else in this outside of just saying this Notion workspace is something that is completely connected with one another. If someone wants any specific aspect of my Notion workspace to be broken down more in depth, please ask in the comment section down below. I'm very open to spreading it out, and this is exactly how I build out my entire life in Notion. There are so many different ways that this interconnects, and this is actually, I mean, a widget I didn't even explain, but there are so many different things about Notion that I realized that I've been working on and know for a while. So I feel like I'm doing a disservice by not making videos about it. I've been doing that for the last year. If people want templates and all that kind of stuff, I'm willing to make my content go more in that direction. I think this is something that keeps me extremely organized and effective. So if anyone's interested in that, please let me know.
So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. I think, you know, there's a lot of different aspects of my Notion workspace that are going to really be useful. Personally, I think, you know, going through like some sort of content ideas breakdown, I think a journaling video would be very good. I think maybe me building out a second brain in Notion, which is something, it's like a buzzword I've heard a lot, but in all seriousness, it's like a very tangible way that you can build out a second brain in Notion. So a lot of your ideas are living in there. And I think there's a lot of different things in my Notion workspace that can be tackled. Even like there's some job application stuff, right? I have like a job application template. I think that would be helpful, considering I did a decent job of like getting focused on like figuring out what kind of job I wanted after college, and then went into the field that I ended up wanting to go to. And there's a lot of different parts of it that I think would be useful. So if you guys have any ideas regarding stuff that you saw in this video, if you want to see a more in-depth thing about how I plan my week, I definitely have it more figured out than maybe I showcased in the video, but I wanted to kind of give you a taste of everything, and then we can go from here and see what you guys want to watch. So with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I appreciate every single one of you. And with that being said, I will see you guys in the next one.